Inspired by Porsche's winning LMP cars, the Carrera GT was the first production car built around a carbon fiber monocoque and subframe. And it featured the world's first production ceramic clutch. The Howling V10 was a relic of the Le Mans prototype that never saw production. And the shift knob is wood, harkening back to the legendary 917 race car.
So yeah, welcome back everyone to Forza Motorsport 6, continuing on with the Porsche anthology. And yeah, we're in the Carrera GT at Yas Marina and four laps, so let's get started. So yeah, there's three races with this car, and then I'm pretty sure the 918 is the final car after this. So yeah, not much left in this series, but highly enjoyed it nonetheless, so let's get going. It's like a big collection of different kind of supercars, and hypercars even, to be honest. Jaguar alongside us, and Enzo as well. Yeah, we're all in the 90s to early 2000s here. Absolutely love the engine in this car. Wish Porsche would try and make a V10 again, because yeah, the engine in this is purely gorgeous. Chip McLaren, dirty racer. Alright, we're into fifth. So yeah, we've made up quite a few positions so far. Kind of outbreak myself there. Oh dear, hit the McLaren as a result. Sorry, should have looked where I was going. And the F50's gone into a wall. Well, that's probably improved the looks of it, because, yeah, ugly car nonetheless. Right, third position, fellow Porsche up front. Don't know what first place is in. I remember driving that Mercedes on a episode. Yeah, I used that in a main career mode at one point. Second lap. I'll have to settle for third at this rate, because yeah, that Porsche is the same as me, but it's got a decent gap, and whatever first place is in is pretty quick as well, even though we are catching him up somehow. Oh, he's in a McLaren. I think he's in the McLaren anyway, it looks like. Yeah, that isn't the normal McLaren F1, that's the, I think it's the GT version, so it's not as quick, but it's a lot better in terms of handling. sneaky Mercedes again. Might be being a bit too cautious, to be honest. Certainly not the easiest Porsche to drive, being relatively lightweight, but got all that power going just to the rear wheels. I find it to understeer a fair bit, though. That's probably just how I'm driving it. Now we've got Enzo behind us, got more power than we do, that's for sure. Sorry Enzo, didn't mean to do that. Caught up slightly. Oopsie daisy. Needed to brake a bit better there. Right, last lap. Finally made it to second. I do really, really like this car. I'm not the best at driving it, that's for sure. Certainly not the easiest thing in the world to get around a track. Oopsie daisy. It's one of the few tracks that, despite me not being all that good on it, is a clear, good mix between big straights and tight corners. Some tracks seem to be weighted to one or the other half the time, but yeah, this gets that mix perfect, quite frankly. Well, gonna have to settle for second, but yeah, at least we were able to progress now. Not gonna have to do it again, that's for sure. So yeah, we're gonna be at Rio full in the next race, so see you when we get there. No narration at the start of this, and we're jumping straight into it. Hopefully we don't do worse than we did last time. Fellow Porsche up front, and also Carrera GT02 as well. Sorry Mercedes, but I don't know why he braked so heavily there. Demo derby on these races. See Daisy. That was annoying. Like stepped out and then overcorrected. It's one hell of a bumpy track, this. Certainly exposes any flaws in suspensions of cars. Mercedes is rocking around a fair bit. Get off me cone. Get off. Slowing me down. Sorry, not sorry, F50, but yeah, I don't like you anyway, so I'm not gonna be upset about doing that. I was forced into doing that. God damn it. That Maserati just comes out of nowhere. Driver tires seem to be way aggressive than they are normal. Wrong. This has been a bit of a nightmare of a race, this. Well, I thought I could take that corner flat, but obviously I can't. Oh dear, oh dear. That went really, really wrong. Yeah, I'm not really driving on this track all that much, and this car, I certainly haven't been on this track before with. It's kind of playing havoc with me. Kind of wish they were like showcase. I don't know whether they are or not. I might have missed the fact that there is, but like on Dirt Rally, where you can try out a bit of the track first before you start the race. It helps you learn the track with the car. I don't know if there is that with this. There probably is, I don't know, but it would be handy. Buy whatever car that was. Once again, we're in second place. Damn it, I'm not going to rewind again. Done enough of that this race so far. And I know the car looks odd with one wing mirror, but it's not the end of the world, is it? So the rest of the car's in mint condition after all the bashing and crashing it's had to go through. In part down to me, but gravitars don't help in that case. Just this track with this car. And again, it's not a track that's often featured in many of these series. I don't think I've been on this with a Porsche in this anthology yet, I'm not sure. If I have, it was in a lot slower car than this. I'm catching up. Oh, really, really close to having him then. But yeah, second place again, with a fairly beat up Porsche. Yeah, you're going to have to get a repairman in for that. Million? No, half. Oh well, money's money. So yeah, final race is at Daytona Infield, so we'll see you when we get there. No speaking at the beginning again, but nonetheless, means we can dive right in. So yeah, not much left of this anthology. I'm pretty sure the 918 is the final car. Though again, I was wrong last time. I thought it was the final car, so yeah, 5 laps as well. Oh dear, didn't like those bumps then, did it? Oh dear, the Jag got hit. Oh, it hit someone else and got flung away. It's really, really tight courses until we get to the banked corners. So dealing with a bunch of wide supercars around here is really a bit of a task. It's a good job we got 5 laps, to be honest. Clown's gonna fly away, surely. Yeah, there it goes. Oh no, it got blocked by the Jag. Thank you, Jaguar. Cause you're certainly not as quick as me. Whoa, nearly took me out there. Nudging 200 mile an hour. Just weigh the anchors. F50 broke a bit too late, and that's even going slower than I was. Here again. Right, come on, let's catch up to these guys. Let's see if we can. Cause yeah, we're not the most powerful car here, and there probably are ones with a higher top speed than me as well, like McLaren. I'm pretty sure the Ferraris. A lot quicker as well. Oh, hit 200 mile an hour there. That's good to see. That McLaren was well catching up with me as well, and look how far it made up. Bit too late there. Sorry, Ferrari. Didn't mean to do that. No surprise that Bugatti EB110 is up front, behind, in front of me. Because that might not be the best handling supercar here, but it's certainly got all the speed that it can ever need. I fear I'm a bit outclassed on this race. May well be a car that can do well more than 200 mile an hour, but it's all about getting to that top speed, and I'm not the fastest to get to that top speed. Because yeah, look, that Celine has less horsepower than me, but look how fast it's going. And then the McLaren, obviously. Doesn't mean I can brake lighter though than them. Come on, two more places to make up at least. Brake delay again on that exact same corner as last time. Don't need to rewind this far back, game, thank you. At least we made it into fourth, so we only have to make up one more place now. Which I hope we can do. Certainly made some ground up there. Get past this fellow Carrera GT. Oh, never mind. Thank you, Mercedes, for that. Made my life a lot easier. Was going to say if we get past the Carrera, then at least it won't be able to get past us on the straight, because, yeah, we are the same car after all. Never mind. Balls it up already. Right, final bit now. So yeah, this has easily been one of the harder ones with a specific car from this anthology. Because yeah, this Carrera GT isn't the easiest of the cars from Porsche. Might be the worst position we've had with this car, but third is third, means we have won overall. So yeah, there we go. The Carrera GT, one of the best cars I've ever made, by a long way. So that's all three done.
You've completed all races for the Carrera GT.
So yeah, I'm pretty sure the 918 Spider is the final car in the anthology. So yeah, I look forward to driving that, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!